the Apostles, chapter number 3. The Acts of the Apostles, please. Chapter number 3. Now, chapter 3 of the Acts of the Apostles begins with a mighty miracle. And you remember how Peter and John went up to the temple, and it was the hour of prayer. And you remember as they went into the temple or heading through the gate, there was a man there who was lame from his mother's womb. And he was there at the temple gate called Beautiful, asking of alms of those who were passing by. But when Peter and John was passing by, they didn't give him alms, they gave him something more wonderful. And Peter, fixing his eyes on this man, says, "Silver and gold have I none, but such as I have I give unto thee. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth," he said, "rise up and walk." And it says, and immediately he arose, and he jumped up and he leaped and he praised God for what God had done for him. And the people marveled and were filled with amazement of what was done. And in verse number 12 we read these words, "And when Peter saw it, he answered unto the people, Ye men of Israel, why marvel ye at this? Or why look ye so earnestly in us as if through by our own power or holiness we had made this man to walk? The God of Abraham and of Isaac and of Jacob, the God of our fathers, hath glorified his Son, Jesus, whom ye delivered up and denied in the presence of Pilate, when he was determined to let him go. But ye denied the Holy One and the Just, and desired a murderer to be granted unto you, and killed the Prince of Life, whom God hath raised from the dead." And then down at verse number 17 it says, "Now, brethren, I wot that ye through ignorance ye did it, as did also your rulers. But those things which God before had showed by the mouth of all his prophets that Christ should suffer, he hath so fulfilled. Repent ye therefore and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out, when the times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord." Amen. And we know that the Lord will add his blessing to that reading of his own precious truth. I could write across my text tonight the text upon which I want to preach the gospel in the closing minutes of this service. I want to put a title upon God's message this evening, and the title would be "The People's Choice." The People's Choice. And what a deadly choice the people made on this day. It was the most deadliest choice ever made since the day when Adam chose to disobey God in the Garden of Eden. You see, this choice tonight involved the lovely Lord Jesus Christ. It involved the one who is indeed God's Son tonight. Don't you ever think this evening that the Lord Jesus was just a good person long ago who went about doing good. Far from it. The Lord Jesus tonight was God's Son. You remember this evening also that the Lord Jesus was not only God's Son, but you remember that the Lord Jesus Christ tonight, he's heaven's door. The Lord Jesus said, "Behold, I am the door. By me, if any man enters in, he shall be saved." You see, the Lord Jesus Christ tonight is heaven's door. The Lord Jesus himself again said in John 14 and 6, he says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no man, regardless to who he is, what he is, or anything about that man, no man," he says, "can come to the Father but by me." You see, this choice tonight was all to do with the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God and heaven's door. But we must remember this evening the Lord Jesus Christ is not only God's Son, he's not only heaven's door, he's the coming judge. And the Lord Jesus Christ is going to come one day to judge this world in righteousness. And Donald Trump and all these great leaders in our world tonight, they're not going to stop him, because everyone will have to bow the knee before him this evening. And I want tonight to bring to you, or God wants me to bring to you this evening, what I call tonight the people's choice. My text tonight is Acts chapter 3, and you'll find it down at verse number 14. Now here's the people's choice. Peter said, "But ye denied the Holy One and the just, and desired a murderer to be granted unto you." And I could write across that text tonight, the people's choice. "But ye denied the Holy One and the just, and desired a murderer to be granted unto you." Do you know what this people failed to see tonight? And what so many people of the day fail to see? That the choice that they make concerning the Lord Jesus Christ determines where they will be in eternity. I don't use the term spend eternity, because you cannot spend eternity. Eternity is forever and ever and forever and ever. And this choice tonight concerning the Lord Jesus Christ not only determines where one will be in eternity, but where one will be in a million, million years from now. The choice that people make. In this choice tonight, I see it as a choice of denial. Because this text begins with these words, "But ye have denied the Holy One and the just." Do you see the choice that the people made that day when the Lord Jesus stood before Pontius Pilate? It's the same choice that people are making today. It's the same choice that people are making on these very Lord's Day mornings and Lord's Day evenings. It's the same choice that people make, even in this town of Kilkeel. It's the same choice that Protestants make. It's the same choice that Catholics make. It's the same choice that everybody makes this evening. Most people make the choice of denial. Do you know, dear unsaved friend, what these people couldn't understand? As to what a whole lot of people cannot understand in our day and in our generation, the cost that comes with the choice of denial. Let me warn you this evening, dear unsaved friend, the choice that comes with the cost that comes with the choice of denial is a lost soul in the fires of hell. The choice of denial. "But ye have denied the Holy One and the just." For one to deny the Lord Jesus tonight is to deny his love. The one Who denies the Lord Jesus Christ tonight is the one tonight who denies his mercy. The one tonight who denies the Lord Jesus Christ is one who denies his saving grace. Do you see the person tonight who chooses to deny the Lord Jesus Christ is to deny their only hope, their only hope for heaven. Let's get it right tonight. They who deny the Holy One and the just denies God's Son. The one who denies the Holy One and the just denies tonight heaven's door. And the one tonight who denies the Holy One and the just denies the coming judge. You see in that text tonight, the people's choice was a choice of denial. And I wonder tonight in this meeting, is there someone here? And how many times already you've made that choice? Oh, and days gone by, yes, maybe weeks gone by, maybe months gone by, maybe years gone by. Oh, he called you. He spoke to you. He convicted you. And sadly and foolishly, you spurned him. And you denied the Holy One and the just. It was 1744. The great preacher John Wesley was preaching in a place called Miller's Barn outside Rossendale in Lancaster. Two friends rode on horseback to hear the great preacher preach the gospel at Miller's Barn. They arrived and just got seated, and everybody waited with great anticipation for the preacher to preach the gospel. John Wesley stepped forward with a little Bible in his hand, went over to the makeshift reading desk, opened his Bible and announced his text. His text was Matthew 27 and verse 22. They were the words of Pontius Pilate when he cried, "What shall I do then with Jesus, which is called Christ?" They said the moment Wesley stepped forward and announced his text, the power of God fell that dramatically, you would have heard a pin drop. And that very sermon that Wesley preached at Miller's Barn was written down, and these were the headings that he used. He says those words should bring everybody to their realization as to how wretched sinners they are in the sight of God. And then he went on, and he said that them very words this evening should bring wretched sinners to the place of repentance. And then he paused. 3/4 of the way through his sermon, he paused and said these words should bring a sinner to the place of regeneration. And he quoted John chapter 1, verse 12. But as many as received him, to them give he the power to become the sons of God. Before John Wesley finished his sermon, three quarters of the people that night in Miller's Barn got out of their chairs and fell on their knees and faces on the floor, crying out to God for mercy, forgiveness, and for salvation. The two boys that rode on horseback, they remained seated. John Wesley looked at every person remaining seated and pointed at those who were on their faces on the ground, said, "For as many as received him, to them give he power to become the sons of God." One of the two boys, he went down on his hands and knees, cried out to God for mercy, but the other boy, he just sat there. In the closing of his message, while these folk were on their faces crying out to God for mercy and for salvation, Wesley closed the sermon with these words. Looking at those who were remaining seated, he says, "As they receive him, you deny him, the Holy One and the Just, you deny." After the service was over and the counseling all took place, the two boys jumped onto the horse's back and headed home. They got about a mile and a half when something in the hedge startled the horse, and the horse reared up. The young lad that wasn't saved, he was sitting in the back and was thrown off. And as he got off, and as his friend got the horse saddled, he jumped off, held his friend in his arms, and watched him dying. And you know what his young friend said to him? When he passed away, he says, "Ye have denied the Holy One and the Just." It's an awful way to die. It's an awful way to go to eternity, denying the Holy One and the Just. It was the choice of denial. And then I want you to notice this text tonight. It was a choice of desire. Because Peter says, "But ye desired a murderer to be granted unto you." How pathetic and how sickening was their choice. They denied the one that gives life. And desired the one that took life. They denied the Savior. Desired a murderer. You may say to me, "Ah, George McConnell, that's not me tonight." Let me tell you, friend, sin's a murderer. And what the worst thing is about sin tonight, it not only kills the body, it kills the soul. Because you see, the wages of sin is death. And sin, the Bible says tonight, bringeth forth death. And tonight there's people who deny the Lord Jesus and still desire their sin. And your sin tonight will take you to hell. And my friend, it doesn't matter tonight what you've done. If you deny the Holy One and the Just, sin will take you to hell. You see, sin tonight's worse than a murderer. Because sin tonight kills the soul. And it's sad how many tonight deny the Lord Jesus and yet desire sin. You know, another gospel says that Barabbas was a robber. It was. And in another gospel it says he was a murderer. You know, friends, sin is a robber. It robs you of heaven tonight. Sin robs you of happiness. Sin robs you of hope. And sin tonight robs you of peace. You prepared tonight to deny the Holy One and the Just, who went all the way to Calvary. And on an old rugged blood-stained cross, as these girls brought us to in their final peace, who gave his life upon that cross to set you free from the penalty and punishment of sin. Is that the one you still want to deny? Is that the one you still turn your back on? Is that the one tonight who you will join with the voices of the crowd and say, I will not have this man rule over me? But you know, friend, tonight there's a lovely wee verse that Peter says, even though you made that choice away back then, the Lord Jesus is still waiting. And he's still calling. And there's still hope. And in chapter 4 and verse 4, we read these, and howbeit many of them which heard the word believed, and the number of the men was about 5,000. The people's choice that day, when the Lord Jesus stood before them on Pilate's judgment hall, was one of denial and one of desire. But this day, 5,000 made a different choice. They believed on him that was crucified. They believed on him that was raised again. And tonight, God affords you that same opportunity to believe on him who died and rose again. Will you believe tonight? Let's bow in a wee word of prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we just seek thy face tonight. We realize, Lord, tonight this choice demands an answer. And we pray for any this evening that's still not saved, that, Lord, you'll give them the grace to make the choice to believe, and to believe now. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.